In this video, I'm going to share a few color grading hacks in Resolve that will instantly elevate the quality and production value of your films. I'll focus on a magical fix for skin tones, a better way to dehaze, how to add character to your digital footage, an awesome way to add more depth to your image, and a neat noise reduction trick. Hack number one, we're looking at a really easy way to fix skin tone in problematic scenes. Usually one would use the offset wheel to balance the image out, often using the skin as an anchor point. The problem is that sometimes balancing for the skin actually throws out the rest of the image. This is usually caused by some sort of a color cast bouncing or shining directly onto the skin without affecting the overall ambience of the shot. What you want to do here is to isolate the skin using the color warper. Simply hover over the part of the skin you want to fix and it will indicate it in the color warper with a little square, so you know where to make your selection. Now click on the relevant pin and go to invert selection. This will select all the pins except the one you clicked on. Next, you need to lock it into place so that only the relevant pin can be adjusted. Now simply open your vector scope and drag the part of the skin into submission on the skin tone line. If you can't select the exact part, you might need to enlarge the grid size on the hue and saturation, which will give you more options to pinpoint the exact area. In this case, the most important part of the skin is back to neutral, and the green you're getting on the left is a natural cast that comes from the lighting bouncing against the green tanks. If you do the before and after, you can clearly see how much the skin has improved, and it only took a few seconds. Hack number two is all about adding more character to your digital footage. There are multiple effects one can apply to your footage to take the digital edge off, but one I use a lot is this prism blur that comes standard with Resolve. You're welcome to copy my base settings, but the trick is to dial it into a more subtle level and to make sure the most important part of the image is not affected. You can take it a step further by adding a progressive lens blur that stretches out towards the edges. Something you would expect from vintage and anamorphic lenses. Create a vignette using a power window and invert it. In the next node, add the tilt shift effect. You'll have to dial in a few settings to get the right look, so if you want, you can download my free power grade linked in the description below. The most important setting is to change the map source to the second input. This will create an extra input point, and now you can just connect the vignette to the second green arrow. And voila, you've got a realistic looking progressive lens blur. Hack number three is all about adding more depth to your image using power windows. Instead of just making certain areas brighter and other darker, how about creating some dappled light that didn't exist in the first place? If the image was shot a bit brighter, it's easier to pull off because you don't have to increase the exposure too much. But this works better on brighter areas where boosting the highlights introduces minimal noise. Once you've made your selection, you can track it against the wall. Just make sure you exclude the tracking on the actor. The next step would be to bring the actor to the front, and here Magic Mask does the trick. Simply select your subject and invert Magic Mask to exclude the subject. If it tracks correctly, you'll totally fool your audience. Now before I carry on, I'd like to thank the sponsor of this video. With more and more people moving over from Premiere Pro and Final Cut, the amount of plugins available for Resolve is growing rapidly. I've been using Motion VFX for the past 3 years now for a variety of functions in all my videos. From motion graphics to creative transitions and title animations, their library for Resolve is ever expanding. These plugins are incredibly easy to use, and you don't need to read a guide or watch a tutorial to understand how they function. Simply drag and drop and customize to your own liking. For my tutorials and courses, I heavily rely on the MTutorial plugin to make it more interesting to follow along and easier to comprehend. It doesn't matter what your niche is, they've got something for everyone. With Black Friday coming up, Motion VFX is running some crazy specials and they're calling it Black Weeks. Check out the link in my description for more info. Hack number four is to dehaze footage. Now there are two scenarios where you would want to do this. The first is if you overdid it with a mist filter. In other words, the mist effect was a bit too strong and you've lost too much contrast. And the second is if you overcooked a scene with haze. Resolve already has a built-in dehaze tool, but I never use it because I feel that it adds too much saturation to the image, and there's a much better way to do it. If you compare it with manually crushing the blacks with curves and primaries and the dehaze tool, you will clearly see why I prefer it. Select the last node in your node tree and right-click to change the composite mode to soft light. This will instantly add contrast and color back to the image without making it feel underexposed. If the effect is too intense on the blacks, you can always dial it down a notch by using a key and dropping the percentage. Hack number 5, we'll have a look at a better way to do noise reduction. The only thing worse than an image with noise is an image that looks like it's been treated with noise reduction. There are so many tutorials about it out there, but I actually disagree with most of them. A lot of them will tell you to use temporal noise reduction, and yes, it is super effective, but it can also alter the motion of your image, quickly destroying the organic feeling it had. I'm not talking about the plastic effect of adding too much noise reduction, but when it actually alters the frame rate, making it feel more digital. The best way to noise reduce is to use the standard spatial noise reduction. The trick is to drag the slider to the point just before it doesn't make a big difference anymore. Now what you want to do is to identify the most problematic areas in your image, usually the darkest parts of the scene, and to isolate it with the qualifier. Immediately select the Luma option, which means you're not looking at hue or saturation, but only luminosity. Now select the darkest parts of the image most affected by noise, and give it a nice gentle feather into the brighter parts of the image. This way you're only applying noise reduction to the most problematic areas. Next, what you want to do is to sharpen the image a bit. So on the very last node, select the qualifier again, only focusing on luminance. But this time you want to select only the brightest parts of the image. This way you're doing minimal softening to the bright areas and minimal sharpening to the darker areas where it's not really needed. And now you can add sharpening to only those areas. If you want more in-depth explanations of this, feel free to check out my Resolve grading course in the description below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.